The Philippine Coast Guard says it has monitored over 135 Chinese maritime vessels in the area of Julian Felipe Reef in the West Philippine Sea. The PCG first monitored at least 111 Chinese vessels in the area in November, but the number has since increased. National Security Advisor Eduardo Año now directing the Coast Guard to carry out maritime patrols in the area. The PCG also said they issued radio challenges to the Chinese vessels, but received no response. At least one person was killed after a 7.4 magnitude earthquake rocked parts of Mindanao late Saturday evening. Four others were injured. Strong aftershocks were also recorded. But the Philippine Institute of Volcanology and Seismology says the quake is not connected to the 6.8 magnitude tremor that rocked Sarangani in November.
Nothing to do with the earthquake last night. So magkaiba po yung generator noon. The one that generated the earthquake in November 17 is the Cotabato Trench. Kagabi is the Philippine Trench. Hindi po stress transfer yung nangyari dito. Magkalayo po yan. Stress transfer happens only sa faults na magkakalapit just few kilometers apart. Dito po magkalayo po yung Cotabato Trench and Philippine Trench.
The initial quake triggered tsunami warnings, which were later downgraded across the Pacific region. Residents were also advised to stay on alert for aftershocks. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., meanwhile, assures the public government is working to help quake victims. The president also calling on Filipinos to unite during these challenging times. Marcos added the Social Welfare Department and Interior Department are collaborating with local government units to provide aid to quake-hit communities in Mindanao. And in Mindanao, as the Islamic State claims responsibility for the deadly blast in Marawi. On its Telegram channel, the group claimed its members detonated the bomb. The explosion killed at least four people and left dozens more injured. It was carried out during a Catholic mass inside the gymnasium of the Mindanao State University in Marawi. Philippine authorities vowed to leave no stone unturned in the hunt for the perpetrators.
Let us remember that this was done in a religious occasion in Marawi, and the intent really to foment terrorist activity, to foment confusion, chaos, is a prime initial of a terrorist activity.
The operations will remain unabated, and our focus now on the in the face of this incident in Marawi will be to not only address the security dimension but also the wellness dimension of the community.
The blast also followed a series of military operations against pro-Islamic State groups in the southern Philippines.
Maaring retaliatory attack. That is one angle that we are looking into. And we have alerted also our units, all of our units in Mindanao, as well as our other units, just like with the Philippine National Police here in the Metro Manila area.
The Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos condemned the attack, calling it a senseless and heinous act perpetrated by foreign terrorists. He also extended his condolences to the victims of the bombing. Survivors of the deadly bombing recount the moment of the explosion. They say the blast happened right in the middle of the mass. Panic and chaos then ensued as they tried to leave the gymnasium.
Nagkakanta na kasi kami, tapos may biglang pumutok sa likod namin. Akala ko nauna, speaker lang ko talaga yun. Tapos biglang nagtakbuhan na yung iba. Ako, yung kasama ko, medyo nadapa pa kami. Tapos sabi ko na, heart, tumakbo ka talaga. Kaya yun lang po talaga yung naalala ko na paglabas ko ng gym, doon po ako nadapa. Yung kasama ko na umiiyak sila kasi may sugat na pala ako sa likod.
Pumunta kami sa simbahan po, 7 a.m. po, tapos nag-start ng isa, tapos yung lahat, Nakafocus lang po sa ano ba, sa mas ng sa mga wali ng pare. Tapos nung ano na, nung first reading na po ng ano, ng magbabasa na, bigla na po may, ano, may sumabog ba? Biglaan lang po talaga. Tapos doon, nagstakbuhan po ang lahat. Tapos yung iba na, yung pagpagalingin ko sa likod, yung iba yung nakahiga na lang sa ano, nakahiga na sila sa sahig po ba?
The university gym appeared intact except for burn marks in the center where the explosion occurred. Mindanao State University has suspended classes until further notice. More government officials vow to seek justice for the Marawi blast victims. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri says best effort should be exerted in bringing justice and restoring peace in Marawi. Lanao del Sur Representative Zia Alonto Adyong also vows to hold accountable those behind the attack.
The degree of the damage and also the casualties and the number of deaths, I would really say that this is a terrorist attack. Let us not mince words here.
Vice President Sara Duterte, meanwhile, appeals to the public to remain calm and vigilant in the wake of the bombing.
Nakikiramay po ako sa mga pamilya ng mga biktima ng pagsabog ng bomba sa loob ng Mindanao State University sa Marawi City nitong araw ng Linggo. Nakakabahala na ito ay nangyari sa loob ng MSU compound sa isang katolikong simbahan, sa isang bahagi ng bansa na may mahaba at madugong karanasan sa terorismo. Dapat ay maging matatag tayo sa harap ng mga hamon at patuloy na banta ng terorismo. Huwag nating hayaan na magtagumpay ang kasamaan laban sa bayang nagkakaisa para sa kapayapaan.
The Marawi bombing also drawing condemnation from the international community. The U.S. calls it an act of violence, adding it supports efforts to hold the perpetrators accountable. The European Union, meanwhile, says violence has no place in a civilized society. It also said the attacks is an assault to its commitment of creating a safe and inclusive community for all. As for Japan, it said it's deeply saddened by the tragedy. It also reaffirmed its support for the Philippines in the goal of achieving lasting peace in Mindanao. Pope Francis offers prayers for the victims of the Marawi blast on X. The Pope sent a message of assurance to those affected by the deadly bombing. He added he is close to the people of Mindanao, whom he said have already suffered so much. Over now to France for an update in the killing of a German-Filipino tourist in Paris. Authorities say the suspect had pledged allegiance to the Islamic State. The 26-year-old man is in police custody and is being investigated for other terror-related offenses.
The perpetrator had recorded a video before committing the act. This film, speaking in Arabic, he introduced himself as Abu Tala al-Khurasani, which is a reference to the Islamic State terrorist organization currently operating from Afghanistan. The investigation is immediately opened based on the counts of murder in connection with a terrorist organization, attempted murder in connection with a terrorist organization, and terrorist criminal association with a view to prepare crimes against people.
The suspect stabbed the 23-year-old German-Filipino tourist in central Paris Saturday evening. Two others were hurt. Prior to the attack, France is already on high alert due to the war in Gaza.